So good morning. Yes, problem number 9. So it's actually combinations audit. A hemisphere of 90 mm in diameter is centrally joined to the end of a cylinder. End of a cylinder of 60 mm diameter. 60 mm diameter. The height of the cylinder is 90 mm. Draw the isometric projection. Please read it. This is an isometric projection of the combination of the solid. Then hemisphere. So right side you can see the front view. This is the front view. Front view, top view of the combination of solid, and this is the isometric projection. Actually, in this figure, the isometric scale is not shown, but you are supposed to draw the isometric scale when you are solving the problem. So please, once again, you must draw the isometric scale when you solve the questions under isometric projection. So you read the, what is the dimensions of the cylinder? Actually, you can look like it is a small rivet. Okay, here is a cylinder with diameter of the cylinder is, diameter of that cylinder is 90 mm, diameter is equal to cylinder is 60 mm, and height of cylinder is 90. And yeah, so this is the diameter. So when you top view, that will be height by the, because this is a cylinder with height is equal to 90 and which is standing above, we placed a hemisphere of diameter is equal to 40 or radius equal to 45. Radius equal to 45. Clear? So then, so once you completed the front view and top view, so you can enclose, you can enclose the cylinder in appearance. Cylinder in appearance will be a circle. That is the inside, it is shown. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4. So initially you include or enclose the circle in a square. Circle in a square. Why it is hidden? Because when you are looking from top, the cylinder is hidden. You place the sphere above this cylinder. Place the sphere, a hemisphere above this cylinder. So it is hidden. So you mark it as 1, 2, 3, 4. So above that we have hemisphere. Hemisphere, and you can enclose the hemisphere in the top of it appearance as circle with dia is equal to 90. So you can again enclose that circle in a square. So that is marked as 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we are moving to the isometric projection. Please remember, this is isometric projection, IP, isometric projection. So isometric scale is important. Isometric scale. You need to draw isometric scale. So all the dimensions appear in this isometric projection is equivalent to your isometric scale, except when you are drawing the this circumference of your hemisphere. So what do you initially, you start with 1, because initially first we are going to draw the isometric projection of your cylinder. Okay, so what is a cylinder? Bottom face is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is a 1, 2, 3, 3 and 4. Clear? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what about, what you can do? So once you this length will be the isometric length corresponding to the 60. Why it is 60? Because the diameter of the cylinder, end of a cylinder is diameter is 60. So this 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1, all are equal to isometric length corresponding. This is equal to isometric length corresponding to the isometric IS, isometric length corresponding to 60, IS 60. Okay. So once you completed 1, 2, 3, 4, you can draw the isometric projection of the bottom face of cylinder by using four center method. That is from 3 to center of this point, from 3 to center of the opposite point, then you get, then from 1 to opposite point, then 1 to this one. So now you can get four centers. First center, second center, third center, and the fourth center. Now you can complete the isometric. View projection of the bottom face of the cylinder. Okay. Now from this point, so what is the height of the cylinder? Height of the cylinder is equal to 90. So let it be, this is P. From P, you mark O. What is the height of P? What is the length? O, it has a height of, what is, how much? This height is equal to isometric length corresponding to OP is equal to isometric length corresponding to 90. Isometric length corresponding to 90. So once you located O, there you can also draw the top face of cylinder. Actually, in final, it is hidden. That is, it is hidden. So what you can do? Here the same naming. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same naming. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there you can complete the isometric of the top view of the cylinder. Now we think about above this cylinder, hemisphere is resting. So as I mentioned the earlier problem, the top surface of the hemisphere is a circle, and which is attached to the, which is at the excuse me, which is attached to the top face of the cylinder. So next we need to draw the isometric projection of the top face of the hemisphere. Okay, hemisphere. So what do you do? From this O, you can complete. From this O, you know the top, it is named as 5, 6, 7, 8. So what you can do? Through O, you can draw two lines. Through O, you draw 130 degree line and another 30 degree line. Okay, so now what do you do? Suppose 5, 6 is your X1, your X. Suppose 5, 6 is X. This is X. Okay, this is X. Suppose this is X and this is Y. Both are same because it is a circle. So from O to, you have to take the half of the isometric length corresponding to the 5, 6. Mark it here, then mark it here. Okay. Then similarly, you take the half of the isometric and the corresponding to Y, mark it here and mark it here. So what is, so this one point, second point, third point, and the fourth point. Now what you can do? You can complete, you can draw 5, 6 parallel to this line. Parallel to this line. Okay, which is passing through this cutting point. Similarly, we can draw 6, 7 passing through this point parallel to 8, 5. So you will get the isometric of projection of this. Now this one is okay, 7, 8 and 8, 5. Clear? Now you can complete the isometric of the surface. Top surface of the what is it now? It is the top face of the, or facing of the isometric projection of the facing of your sphere. Once it is completed, OA center. Now next thing, OA center. What is the radius here? This isometric projection. So here radius is original radius. Original radius. It is equal to 45. Original radius. Original radius. Okay. Original radius. Clear? Okay. Okay, it's time for discussion. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So it's a combination only. You follow the first. You draw the isometric projection of your cylinder, and the sphere is hemisphere is cylinder. So next, you draw the isometric projection of the hemisphere. Clear? Okay, any doubt?
Sorry, hemisphere. Circle varikende.
Hemisphere circle. Is there, what is the hemisphere circle? That I explained here. Actually, you need not draw the off surface of the cylinder. That is not shown here. You got it? Because the hemisphere circle is resting or attached with the top surface of the cylinder. Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
Here, I'll show you. What is this shown here? This is corresponding to the circular face of the hemisphere. But here there will be a circular face corresponding to the. It's already there, but it is hide by the, okay, it is hide by the circular face of the your hemisphere. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Any other doubt? So now we move on to the next problem. So just note down this question. January 2010. University question. Okay, or you can take this screenshot. Okay, now we move on to the next question. This is the problem number 10. Actually, it is a combination of three solids. So read the question. An object consists of. This again a university question. Actually, it is not mentioned here. Object consists of hemispherical vessel, 60 mm dia, which is placed centrally over a truncated cone. So this is the first solid, second solid, truncated cone is the second solid of 50 mm base diameter and the 40 mm top face. It is a truncated cone. So it is a bottom diameter and the top diameter. The bottom diameter is 50 mm and the top diameter is 40 mm. Clear? And height is equal to 50. The cylinder is standing placed entirely over a square prism. This is your third solid. Square prism of 60 mm base side and 20 mm height. Draw the. It is again a isometric projection. Please read isometric projection. So as it is an isometric projection, we need to draw the isometric scale. Okay. So first, you draw the isometric square. What are the dimensions? Which are the dimensions coming here? 60 is there, 50 is there, 40 is there, 40 is there, then again 50, then again 60, then 20 is there. 20 is there. So all these dimensions need to represent the isometric scale. Okay. So let's start. So initially, you draw the. Okay, the front view and top view is a combination of solids. There are three solids. The bottom you have a square prism. This is the square prism. This is your third solid, square prism. Okay, square prism. Is that what is square prism? Base side is equal to 60 and height is equal to 20. Okay, above that your second solid. What is second solid? It is a truncated cone. The base diameter is equal to How much is the base diameter? Bottom base diameter. This is 50. This is 50. So this is your second solid. Okay. This is 50. And your what is the top diameter is equal to? This is equal to 40. This is equal to 40. Now your first solid. First solid is a hemispherical vessel. 60 mm dia. 60 mm dia. Clear? So as it is 60 mm, this portion is equal to 30. Now when you are looking from top, which are the hidden and visible. So when you are looking from top, so just you can see the outer of this hemispherical outer of so when you are looking from top, the outer of this hemisphere is visible. So I will use this circle. And what are this here? This cone top diameter and base diameter of hidden. So that's the hidden lines you can see. This is the diameter corresponding to the top of the cone. This is the diameter corresponding to the bottom of the cone. Top and bottom. So inside. So is the then the third one is the outer representing the outer square, which represent the top of your the top view of your square prism. Now we are moving to the isometric projection. So initially you draw the isometric scale. From that, so we'll start the in line with this your horizontal line. What is about AB? AB is isometric length corresponding to the isometric length corresponding to your base edge of your square prism. Isometric length AB. Then you hide the isometric length. This is isometric length. Then you complete the isometric of the square prism. Isometric of the square prism. Now from you connect the corners of your. Here you can see the corners of your square prism. Then you can locate O. So O center, you complete the isometric projection of your center. Isometric projection of your bottom face of your truncated cone. So this actually represent the bottom face of your truncated cone. Clear? So from here, this all these dimensions are with isometric scale length. From you mark what is the height of the solid? Height of the truncated solid is 50. So you can locate O2. This is O2. So O1, O2 is isometric length corresponding to your 50. Isometric length corresponding to 50. Then at O2, you draw the isometric of the top surface of your truncated cone. Top surface of the truncated cone. Then from O2, you locate the center of what is this distance? Center of the sphere. That is from O2, this distance is what is this distance? Locate O3. From O2, you locate at the height of isometric length corresponding to 30. Isometric length corresponding to 30. So this is isometric length corresponding to 30. Isometric length corresponding to 30. Then at O3, you complete the isometric of the projection of the top surface of your hemisphere. So once that is completed, what you can do? O3 as center. So isometric projection of a hemisphere. O3 as center. Original radius. What is original radius? 30 as radius. 30 as radius. You draw the isometric projection of the top surface of the or the circular or the car surface of your hemisphere. Or surface of your hemisphere. Okay. So here we have three solids initially you draw the isometric projection of your square prism, and you locate O1. From O1 you locate, so based on O1 you draw the isometric projection of your bottom face of your truncated cone. From O1 you locate O2, the height of isometric length of 50, isometric length corresponding to 50. Now what about here also, what is this one? This AB is equal to isometric length corresponding to isometric length corresponding to 50. So now once you located O2, you complete the isometric projection of the top surface of your truncated cone. Then from O2 you locate O3 at a height of isometric length of 30. At O3 you draw the isometric projection of the top surface of your hemisphere. Then O3 as center, the radius, there is the change in the dimension. What is the radius here? Original radius, or which is equal to 30. 30 as radius, you draw the circle. Okay, clear? Hello. Oh. Please ask. Okay.